In 2021-2022, Parliament approved 5 billion supplementary budgets to the Ministry of Trade, Industry and Cooperatives for renting of office space. But instead, the ministry diverted funds into renovation of the dilapidated current premises of Farmers House on Parliament Avenue, which sparked off an oversight inquiry from the Committee of Trade.
Our committee is not hunting anybody in the ministry, but our committee wants to know the process, the criteria used to reach to that level. We all appreciate renovation if it was the cheapest, because it's our own building as a country. We really appreciate that. But what was the criteria used? And why was it rushed?
And for them, they were considering renting. But in their own wisdom, they thought instead of renting, they should renovate their building, which they did, but at a different cost. What they had brought was 3.1, but what they initiated was 6.2 billion. So our problem is, how did they come to this?
Trade committee members, however, queried how the Minister of Trade varied the initial assessment contract, which was approved by the Ministry of Works at a sum of 3.1 billion shillings, to 6.2 billion shillings for renovation of the ministry premises.
Of the market survey that was done, that came with that figure of 6.2 billion. We're interested in the justification, how you are able to move, and yet Ministry of Work presented a BOQ of 3.1 billion shillings.
The quotation of 6.2 billion was what, as I told you, the market assessment, which had been done by the procurement department and engineers from works. It was a reserve price. It was a quotation, madam.
The committee today put in corner the assistant secretary of the Minister of Trade, Rose Asimwe, who initiated the 6.2 billion shillings to explain what her interest was in inflating the contract sum and why she assumed powers of her bosses to take charge of the procurement of this controversial contract.
Whether our sister was formally instructed to handle this business, because she's saying right now that she tried to call and there were no response and she went ahead with the business, then it means she's 100% responsible over whatever happened.
Telling us that the undersecretary initiated, yet the lady herself here confessed before this committee that her only process, her only involvement was initiation, and she initiated. Is in order, therefore, to deny that the process was initiated by the undersecretary.
The only stage I was involved, the extent I was involved, was requesting for procurement as a member of the user department.
Meanwhile, the Committee of Trade is also investigating circumstances under which the Minister of Trade allegedly procured second-hand vehicles for ministers, yet they were allocated funds for new vehicles. Parliament voted 2.8 billion shillings to the Minister of Trade for procurement of 5 vehicles for 4 ministers each at 600 million shillings and one for the permanent secretary at 400 million shillings. But it's alleged that instead the ministry went for second-hand vehicles. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.